Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today's video is going to be a little different. Recently on my main channel, I did a product review of this. It's a little emulation handheld machine. Now, on my main channel, I just talk about the pros and cons of this and if you should be interested in buying it. And so if you want to see a product review on this guy, go to my main channel, Wii Scheme. There should be a link popping up. But here I want to talk about something that in the emulation community in general on YouTube and otherwise isn't talked about that much that I've seen, which is the legality or lack thereof of emulation and ROMs, at least here in the United States. So that's what we're going to focus on here. So this is a gaming machine, emulation machine made by a company called Ambernic, which comes preloaded with thousands of games. Are ROMs and emulation legal? The short answer is yes. The long answer is no. So let me explain. Emulation in the United States and ROMs in general have been deemed as a legal usage, a legal thing that you can create. It's fine. The problem is, it would usually require specific licensing to do so, which most games don't give you. What do I mean by that? Well, let's say I've got this cartridge of Jurassic Park for Super Nintendo, and I want to play this without the Super Nintendo. So I download its contents and I create a ROM of it. Now, technically, as long as I'm not distributing its source code or redoing its source code, there's nothing too foul about that. But the licensing of this game often will distinctly state that I can only use this in its cartridge form. It would kind of be like buying a CD and then burning it to a cassette, or vice versa, a cassette and burning it onto a CD rather. Technically, you're still using it for private use at that point, but you have usually infringed upon the license of your purchase agreement. The thing with emulation that makes it even less of a legal precedent, though, is these distributors, unless they've made digital versions of the game, don't have an alternate version that you're not buying. In that example I just gave, maybe, you know, the record company sells the CD version, and if you just burn, or, you know, burn the cassette onto a CD, they could say those are the damages they've assessed as you pirating it that way. But at the end of the day, just like in the music industry, you don't see people getting sued by these labels or these major distributors very often for pirating music, even though it's easier now than it's ever been, or for emulation. And if it's technically not okay to do in most situations, why don't we hear more about legal ramifications? Well, there's a few reasons. One is, when it comes to copyright law, something you have to establish in order to really have a lawsuit go through is damages. Damages done to the company holding the copyright. You can prove that someone infringed on copyright, but if you can't prove that that cost your company money, you're not going to get anything out of it. You're just going to waste a lot of court dollars and hours to say, yep, you did it, and maybe impose a tiny little slap on the wrist fine of $1,000 or something. You're not going to really be able to claim anything serious if there's no damages. And with a ROM, most of our emulated ROMs are from titles that the copyright owners don't even distribute anymore. So to say that there's any sort of damages they've incurred is almost impossible, especially if all you're doing is using it in private use when you already own the original and you're using it on a medium that the owner of the copyright doesn't even provide you to use. The people who should be more concerned are the people who make something like this. Even the main companies doing stuff like this are pretty much under the radar, and the main reason for that is it would still be difficult for them to prove enough damages from something like this to make up for the money they'd have to pay in legal fees, especially finding a company in a different country often. So at the end of the day, if you buy this, the FBI is probably not knocking on your door for your copyright infringement. Now, I would recommend owning copies of the games you're trying to emulate. It gives you a much better legal shield. But honestly, a lot of the times it's what the case is someone used to own these games that they're playing and they don't anymore, and these games are impossible to find. Hence, they're putting them on emulation. So are you going to get in trouble for that? I mean, technically you could, but the odds of it being anything serious are very low. And the odds of anyone pursuing that legislation is even lower, because how are you going to prove damages when you're trying to play games that you couldn't buy if you wanted to? Like, I want to buy these games and I can't find them. So I used to own them, and then I got this because it had those games that I want to play again. How is that company going to say that you cost them money when you couldn't even give them the money if you wanted to, right? And the only way you could buy this anyway, this a game like this, is through a private reseller. And a private reseller selling this game, copy of Jurassic Park, Nintendo makes $0 on this transaction. So why is, you know, why is Nintendo or the company Ocean that made this going to be concerned with you buying a ROM machine that has this game on it that they're not even making money on now if you buy it in this format? So is it technically legal? Usually not. It's kind of like if you're going 5 miles an hour over the speed limit in the U.S. Is it legal? No. Are you going to get pulled over for it? Almost certainly not. And if you do, the ticket's going to be almost nothing. And if you fight it in court, you'll probably get it dismissed. I think the reason you don't hear this conversation come up a lot, or you don't see people too concerned about it, is because just that. It's not a huge concern because the legal waters are very gray and hazy, and emulation in and of itself is perfectly legal. So a company would have to prove both that your version of emulation was not legal and that it caused them some sort of damages or a loss of money. And at that point, if they're going to go after that, they're going to go after the people who are making these, not the people who are buying them. It's not legal advice, okay? I'm not giving you official legal advice. I'm just giving you the facts of how this all works. If you liked the video, comment below your thoughts, or if you learned anything new about emulation and copyright law in the US and all that, comment below what you learned and what you thought was interesting. And also, don't forget to check out my product review of this on my main channel, We Scheme. And until next time, I scheme, you scheme, we all scheme for ice cream. Bye.